Welcome in this session of International Faculty Development Program on Recent Trends in Science and Technology, organized by the Academic Staff College, Suresh Gyanvihari University, Jaipur, India. The title of this session is Price of Unethical Research. And our today's resource person is Professor Dr. Lalit Mohan Kukreja.
Today, we are going to discuss a problem, or rather a subject, which is very important for us, especially at this time when the entire world is reeling from a pandemic. The question is that what is the price that humanity pays for the unethical research? And why I selected this topic? There is a recent event which is worrisome, and we will discuss that. See, there is an old adage that if wealth is lost, something is lost. If health is lost, something is lost. And if character is lost, everything is lost. And if we are doing research which is unethical, everything is lost. We lose wealth, we may even lose health, and definitely we lose the character or the real purpose of doing research. See, our humanity survives on the balance between good and bad. Humanity survives because there are two opposite forces of construction and destruction. And unethical research leads to destruction. For the sake of survival of humanity, not as human, we have to understand here the difference between humans and humanity. See, we few as individuals may like to have benefits, or we may like to have certain wishes fulfilled, which may be of our personal vested interests. But how does it affect the humanity? Humanity is all 7 billion brothers and sisters living together on this planet, and I am just one of them. You are just one of them. Individuals are just individuals out of that large species which we call as humanity. Are we doing good to the humanity? That is the basic question we have to address when we decide to do research. Now, recently, something happened which is very worrisome, and this is about a paper which was published in a journal called Lancet. And I may tell you, Lancet is like the granddaddy of medical journals. This journal is, I guess, about 200 years old, about. And its impact factor is more than 59. It's a very high impact factor. That means this is one of the most respected journal in the world as far as medical sciences are concerned. And a group of researchers, I can even give you a reference of that paper. And this paper was published sometime in May 2020. That means more than a month ago. And the authors of these papers are Mehra M.R., Desai S., Rustika F., and Patel A. And this was published in May 2020. And this paper was very important for the world, because in this paper, they came up with the results that a medicine called HCQ, hydrochloroquine, this is actually a medicine for malaria. But when this pandemic started, you know, President Trump, he touted, I don't know who were his advisors and why he did that, but he made this medicine very famous, telling that this has a prophylactic effect and it can save people from COVID-19. Now the humanity is already under the grip of fear, because there is no therapeutics, there is no vaccine for COVID-19, and politicians such as President Trump made it very famous. Lot of people came to know, and then India supplied this medicine all over the world, and people thought that okay, if there is no therapeutics, there is consume HCQ as a prophylactic and try to prevent COVID-19. But this paper, when it was published in May, it was based on the results from thousands of patients, from hundreds of hospitals, from 6 different continents in the world. And the finding of this paper was that HCQ is dangerous. That is what I understand. I'm not a medical professional, and please don't take any medical opinion from this webinar, because we are not discussing the medical science. We are discussing the ethics of doing science. So people took this paper very seriously, that hydrochloroquine is dangerous. And earlier people thought, because it was touted by President Trump, and even Brazil was using it, and even in India, ICMR recommended that HCQ can be taken as prophylactic, because this may affect the immune system in a positive sense, and this could be an immunomodulator, and the chances of getting COVID-19 may be less. So people were taking it. But once this paper came in Lancet, this paper had a finding that HCQ is dangerous, because the people who were taking HCQ, they had more mortality, because this medicine affects the heart. And COVID-19 also, the fatality rate is high if there are comorbidities like heart problem or kidney problem and things like that. So when this paper, people stopped taking HCQ, because Lancet means people think that in medical world, this is like the best the humanity can produce. But 1 month later, this paper has been retracted. And this paper has been retracted, I think, sometime in June. And on 11th of June, in the Nature, which appears on every Thursday, last Thursday was on 11th of June, there is a nice article which says that this paper was retracted because the authors failed to provide the evidence of the data. All the data on which these findings were based and these results were based from thousands of patients, and this was a very systematic study based on random control trials, and they did not provide the data to the journal, because scientists all over the world wanted to know that what is the truth behind this paper, and we want to see the actual data on which these findings are based. And authors, it seems, refused to give the basic data about the case studies, and the paper was retracted. That all of us, the entire humanity, is suffering because of a pandemic for which there is no vaccine, there is no standard that don't take HCQ, it is dangerous. Some other organization is telling HCQ is prophylactic, so you should take to prevent serious effects of COVID-19. So whom should the humanity believe? And once the paper is retracted and authors are not supporting the data that considered an unethical research or unethical paper, and in a journal like Lancet, as granddaddy of medical journals. Now, why did they do that? And why did journals such as Lancet accept this paper without verification of the basic data? These are the big questions now the world is asking. And in media, I heard that we don't know the reason why people did that, why people gave medical opinion which is based on data which they cannot give it to us for verification or as an evidence. There is no veracity of this data. Why did they do that? One theory, now you see, once you do not know the truth, the needle of suspicion goes that something has been done in an unethical manner. And maybe people had vested interests. They may be political, they may be financial, we don't know. Maybe it is just a guesswork that the journal accepted this paper in hurry because this paper proved HCQ is dangerous, and so it proves that President Trump is wrong, and now this is an election time. So maybe there were some, maybe, I don't know. Maybe there were some political vested interests, or the other vested interest could be, again, as I heard from the media, that once you have a prophylactic medicine such as HCQ, then other medicines such as Remdesivir, which is produced by an American company, and it was also shown that it has some positive effects in managing COVID-19, its value goes down. If there is a prophylactic medicine, okay, and people feel psychologically secured after taking HCQ, maybe the cost of other medicines, who are maybe much more expensive, and there is a huge medical industry behind that, that goes down. So it was proven that HCQ is dangerous and don't take it. And then paper is retracted and the entire humanity is put into confusion. So you see, few individuals, few human beings, for their vested interests, for their, the kind of mind they have, either they have a political ideology or they have financial vested interest in medicines, they can make even such papers and retract it when humanity asks, where is the evidence? Humanity is dying, people are suffering. And some people, some human being, even at this time, cannot refrain or cannot give evidence that what we are telling is truth. So in the same journal Nature, as I told, which appeared on last day, there is a very nice article on that, and I will read from that article. There is a statement given by Ian Kerridge. He is a bioethicist, bioethicist at the University of Sydney, Australia, and he has written about this paper. This whole event is catastrophic. It is problematic for the journals involved. It is problematic for the integrity of science. It is problematic for medicine, and it is problematic for the notion of clinical trials and evidence generation. This is what a bioethicist from University of Sydney, Australia writes. So you see, first this paper was published, people thought that this is something which is for the good of humanity. Then it was retracted. It caused a huge havoc. It has created a lot of loss to the wealth. It has created loss to the health. Maybe some people who were actually supposed to take, HCQ, maybe they stopped taking and they missed the prophylactic effect of HCQ. So maybe some people died. Okay. And certainly this is unethical to not to provide evidence for the data on which such an important result, and that too in the middle of this epidemic, is based. So this is a worrisome situation. Basic purpose of research is to generate new knowledge. So this knowledge should be either driven by our curiosity, because we want to know, we want to understand the nature to whom we belong. We are the belongings of nature. We are the children of nature. I always tell in my seminars, in my talks, that we belong to nature, not the other way around. So we want to understand nature. So it's a very noble cause of doing research, to understand nature, to either address our curiosity or to solve our problems. For example, if we have a disease, through research we should develop vaccine, and people are developing it. People are developing vaccines in many, many laboratories. And even the repurposed medicines are being tried for the therapeutics of COVID-19. And maybe new drugs are being developed. So this is the basic purpose of research, to generate new knowledge, either for us to understand nature or to solve human problems. So how we should prevent unethical science? How we should not do this unethical research? And how we should avoid papers such as Lancet and New England Journal of Medicine and put the entire humanity in confusion in the middle of this pandemic? How we can do that? This is the final question I would like to discuss with you. I think that, human being, deep in his mind, if you study the psychological sciences, they say that human mind has a layered structure. The human mind, not brain, I'm talking of mind, how we think, how we decide, which leads to either a good science or unethical science. So there is a deep mind, which people call as unconscious mind, where we have our likings and dislikings. In Hindi, we call it, dosh, rag and dvesh. there are two terms, rag and dvesh, our likings and dislikings. Deep in our mind, they are embedded, they are there. We like certain things. We like to be popular. We like to earn money. We like to have, you know, lot of wealth. We like to have fame. We like it. We dislike diseases. We dislike discomfort. We dislike isolation. So these likings and dislikings, rag and dvesh, attachments and, you know, dislikes, they are deep in our mind. Then comes our conscious mind, which makes us do things. For example, right now I'm speaking to you, my conscious mind is processing all this information that on the internet I'm talking to you, but the thoughts are coming from deep within. And in between is subconscious mind, or a decisive mind, which is like, you know, an assessor. If from deep mind some negative thought comes, my in-between mind will say, oh, this is negative. Haven't you experienced this? All of us have experienced. This is not something of which we can give scientific evidence, but we have experienced it. When a thought is generated, when thought comes like a bubble from deep in the mind, one mind within my own mind tells me either it's a good positive thought or is it a destructive or negative thought. And then this thought goes to conscious mind, and conscious mind makes us do things. We start acting. Okay? For example, from deep within my mind, a thought comes that I should publish a good paper. Good? So I should do experiment. My conscious mind says I should do experiments. I should find the truth about nature. But when I find the truth, I find that either this truth is already known, because nowadays a lot of knowledge is existing, and I cannot publish it. But then a thought comes, oh, let me change the title, let me, you know, cook the data. But I should publish it because I want to publish it so that I get my PhD degree. And right at that time, my conscience, my in-between mind says, "Arey yaar, ye theek to nahi hai." So you see, there is a generation of ideas, there is an assessor or examiner of ideas, and there is a faculty to implement that ideas within my own mind. You know, now if I say that I have to publish this paper, unethical way may be sahi, who cares for it, at least I'll get a paper, I will publish it. But this paper is useless. Not only useless, it is harmful for myself. One may say, how does it harm me? See, there is a nice story from Mahabharata. I have still a few minutes left. See, before the Mahabharata, Mahabharata, you know, is an old Indian epic. And this is good as a management, you know, teaching. Lot of, you know, skills and lot of teachings we can get for our practical life from epics such as Mahabharata. So there is a story that before this war of Mahabharata started, Krishna, who is considered as a symbol of, you know, ethical powers and the nature's power, and in Hinduism he is considered as God. He actually went to Duryodhana, and Duryodhana told him that I know I am wrong, what I am thinking is wrong, and because I am wrong, this war will happen. I also know that, and lot of people will be killed, there will be lot of bloodshed, I know that, but I cannot stop it. So you see, his mind, because within his mind he had this idea that this unethical thing, this destructive thing, I cannot stop. Then the symbol of, you know, natural power, Krishna, he knows that, okay, if you cannot stop, go ahead. But he knew that it will destroy you. So unethical things are self-destruction. And Mahabharata happened, and you know, all those who have read or heard about Mahabharata, we know that Kauravas were finished. So unethical things are destructive. They are self-destructive. Now one may say that if I have cooked up data and if I have published it, if I have plagiarism and I'm not caught, what way it is self-destructive? You have destroyed your own conscience. If I have done so, if I have, you know, by overriding my conscience, my conscience says that don't do anything unethical, but I do it. I force, I take a strong stand that no, whatever may happen, I will do it. I want a paper, I want my degree, doesn't matter. And I do it. Okay. Then what did I destroy? I destroyed my own conscience. So unethical things are self-destructive. Okay, and let us think over it. So if we are, you know, even at a very personal level, I'm doing unethical things, I'm not fulfilling my natural needs. See, my food, my survival, my protection, I don't increase by doing unethical things. By doing unethical things, what do I get? I get a paper, I get a degree, maybe I get more money, maybe I get more recognition, maybe I get little fame. These are not the basic needs of human survival. These are not my basic needs. These are all man-made concepts. And I cater only to man-made concepts by following the path of unethical science or unethical research. Okay? So let us think over it. Unethical research is risky. Now you see these authors whom I named, they published in Lancet. They were famous for 1 month. Now their face is lost. Okay. In Hindi we say, na, muh kala ho gaya. This journal's face is lost. Lancet publishing such results which they cannot verify, which they cannot provide evidence, which they have no veracity for. Lancet journal ka muh kala ho gaya, authors ka muh kala ho gaya, humanity suffered, maybe some people died, maybe people stopped taking HCQ, and ICMR has still not withdrawn. WHO has restarted after this paper was retracted. WHO has, you can see on the website of WHO, they have again launched the project Solidarity. That means you can take HCQ and give your feedback in that, on that portal, Solidarity. But in the meantime, for 1 month, when pandemic was at its full swing, some people might have not taken HCQ and maybe they died. Because of, you know, some and unethical research, maybe some people lost their lives, authors have lost their face, journal has lost its face, and entire humanity is now questioning that what kind of science these journals are publishing. Helpless, pandemic-stricken people. So unethical work is risky. It is self-destructive at any level. Either at personal level, at organizational level, at institutional level, at national level, or international level. Higher the level, higher the destructive power. But this is self-destructive, and certainly it does not help us in any way. So I will conclude here. The price of unethical research is very, very high. Sometimes It may be very little, but there is always a price for it, and this is not a good price which we pay for unethical research. Thank you very